Wanneer is dat gewoon gezet?
Een podcast.
Hoe maak je smart? Dat kan niet.
Soms is het
ook een
broadcasting people should join, ja. Yeah? So, let's see. Participants are starting to come in. Let's see who is in. Attendees, Milena. Milena, can you hear us, Milena? Write us in the chat window, please. Georgi Zlatev is in the house. Okay. So let's see whether or not Milena can hear. Milena can hear us. So this is extremely cool. Okay. So we're waiting for the people to join. In the meantime, we're getting things ready. As usual, cool poster behind you. Many people, by the way, are asking about that poster, but that's a completely different subject. And what it is, and why is it here, and what does that mean, and many, many other things. So let me also share the screen so that we know what the subject of today's webinar is at the end of the day. So I'll go to screen, share. Okay, brilliant. Okay, so we have 4 participants still. Quite a lot more were actually registered. By the way, in the meantime, Georgi Zlatev is also here, Eva, Milena. Okay. So in the meantime, while we're waiting for some other people to join, because I believe at least 2 or 3 minutes, Maria, you can join me. So we are going to be, Maria will be the host, not the host, the presenter for the day. I will be the host. But still, let's wait for a few more minutes so that people can join. In the meantime, for everyone who is joining, if you have any questions in regards to fonts in PowerPoint and in presentations, let us know in the chat window so that Maria can take a look afterwards and answer any question that you guys might have. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so let's see, we have 4 people still. Okay, let's see the chat window also. Eva is saying hey. Hello. So that's the panelist. At the end of the day, if we don't get more people in 1 or 2 minutes, Georgi, you have like a minute or so to take a coffee or something like this, or popcorn or something, I don't know, something. Take a glass of water, take some popcorn or coffee or beer, and we're waiting for 1 or 2 more minutes, and then we're firing this webinar up. There will be a recording. Let's go here. There will be a recording of this webinar later on tomorrow, maybe at the evening. But again, a lot of interesting content coming up, so let's see. Took my dinner with me. That's a good idea. Okay. That's a good idea. Okay. Hi. So let's see who is here. Still the same people. People are busy today. Jesus. Okay. That's interesting. Waiting a few more minutes.
Yeah.
Waiting a few more minutes. Georgi, by the way, if you have any question in regards to fonts, let us know. Or if you have any question in regards to presentations, you are so privileged right now to ask. So use that special moment, let's go this way, to ask any question. Okay, 4 participants, okay, so that's kind of strange. Okay, anyway, whatever, still. People have the links, they received the link 1 hour ago also. So if that's the case, we'll start.
Okay.
Now, okay, so for all of you who are here and for everyone who is going to take a look at the recording at some point in the future, currently this event is happening on the 28th of May. In 28th of May 2019. Today we're talking about fonts. This is our monthly webinar. You're in the webinar of a company that's called 356 Labs. The company is, I'm Boris, this is Maria, one of our designers, who is going to share with you quite a lot of secrets in regards to fonts and how you can use them to make presentations stunning slides without being a designer. We are a presentation agency. We help our clients write, design, and deliver truly effective presentations by either doing all of those things for them or by training them how they can do that for themselves. Maria personally has been involved in, most of the presentations and some of the most critical presentations that we created as an agency. She loves phones also, which is quite an advantage for everyone who is going to consume that in one way or the other. She has a really serious passion in regards to phones. Participants are now growing. Okay, welcome everybody. So without further ado, I don't have anything else to say or add, but leave you here and wish you really cool time because there are a lot of interesting things coming up. So enjoy the webinar. Maria, it's you.
Thank you, Boris. Hi, everyone. I'm so, so happy to be here and to lead this webinar on one of my favorite topics. Actually, this is my first webinar, so I'm really very excited, but I hope we all will enjoy together. So firstly, I want to begin with why we actually choose to make a webinar on that topic. And the reason is that we are all working with big companies from around the world, and actually what we see is that most of those companies actually don't think about phones that much, let's say, or don't care much about how the letters look like. So that's why we decided to make some clearance around phones and why actually the fonts are so important and how you can make your presentation much more effective using fonts wisely. And of course, the title of this webinar is Fonts, the Voice of Text. And what does this mean? We're gonna reveal just in a few minutes. So stay with us. To begin with, let's see, sorry. So whenever we try to make something as a design, no matter it is a presentation or any kind of other design like flyers or really whatever, we deal with two main elements. And those elements are text and images. And actually, we as human beings living in this modern world, we are engaged with text every day, everywhere. And so in this case, we are also engaged with fonts. Actually, all the texts are using different fonts and we don't even pay attention to them. But they are so, so important for the way we perceive the information that this text is telling us. So today, actually, we are going to shift a little bit the viewpoint and see text as images. So this is a very critical difference, and you will understand why. One of the things that also can somebody think when doing his slides is that, okay, I made the perfect slide. I choose the all the colors are harmonious and all the photos are high quality and everything is so perfect, but somehow something's missing. And what's that thing? And I think you already guessed what it is. Yes, it's the font. Actually, those fonts are something invisible that most of us don't even think about, don't care about fonts. As soon as it's readable, we don't think how what exactly font we use. But it is really important. Yes, fonts do matter. And to understand this, I will give you a very quick example. So I want all of you to read what's on your screens now. And I will ask you to read this text again. So I hope I'm hearing your smiles now, because actually you now understood very easily how just with the help of a font, the text can shift its meaning. Because this text is absolutely the same. The one thing that is different is the font. So you see, the voice that is telling us, I'll always be waiting for you, on this slide is totally different from the voice that's talking to us from this slide. And this is exactly what I mean when I say that the fonts are the voices of text. When we read, we tend to imagine hearing voices. So yes, these voices are actually the fonts. Okay, so let's go on. But to understand what, why actually fonts are so important and so, they really change the way we perceive the world, the text we read. So to understand how they are working, we need to go back to the history of humankind, because actually in the fonts there are layers of information that is adding one by one with the centuries. So we'll see now what's hiding inside the fonts. So these pictures that you see here, they are cave drawings. Those are one of the first examples of how the man is actually saving information. This is the original need of a person to save a kind of information about his life. And also it's connected with the feeling of security. So this person wants to say, hey, I was here and this is true because I made these scratches on the wall. So this is really amazing, and this is how the written communication actually started. Maybe you've also thought about other examples a bit later in the time. Yes, these are the Egyptian hieroglyphs. They are also such kind of writing system, very imagery, and using a lot of images. And in the beginning, it was very simple. When we use an image of a bird, it's just a bird. But later on, this system was developing. It was getting more and more complex, and we'll understand what does it mean. But now I want to stress on something, and this is the fact that actually we tend as human beings to read first with the eyes, not with the mind. So first we perceive the visual information, and that means that we perceive the text as an image, as a picture. So I'm gonna show you one example, and I really hope that you all don't know a Georgian language. So for those of you who are Georgian or who speak Georgian language, maybe the experiment won't work, but for all the others, I hope it will work. So let's imagine that we are in the beautiful town of Tbilisi, and we are searching for an ATM. So the first thing that you see on the street are these two signs, and I bet that you will go after the first sign to search for an ATM. And the reason why you will do this is because this font is much more clear, and it just speaks to us as something that might be like an ATM and not like a candy shop, which is actually the what's written in the words beneath. So you see how even only with visuals we can understand so much about the meaning of the words, even though we don't know them. Okay, so going back to the history, we are now in the Middle East. This is a Sumerian relief, which is very important because of one thing. If you look up on the left side of the picture, you will see some scratches in the stone, but actually those scratches are something really important. These are signs which illustrate sounds. So this is actually the first ever written system, which is the mother of our currently writing system, which we use now. These are letters for sounds as we use nowadays. I'm going very fast through the main writing systems that were developed in the world, in different parts of the world. So the first one is this Sumerian, coming from the Middle East. After that, we are having this Egyptian hieroglyphs writing system, which, as I said, become very complex. And they also developed many images which illustrate sounds. After that, we go to China, where you can imagine today, modern China is using hieroglyphs that are actually dating back 4,000 years ago. So you can imagine what an ancient system we are using now, and how those pictograms actually were very direct. They were like exact pictures, like a tree or like a bird. So they are using these hieroglyphs now again in China. And the other one is the Greek writing system, which is exactly where our Western writing system came from. And maybe you can see this prototype of the letter A. It's not K, as many of you may think. It's the letter A that's hidden here behind this image. So we go a little bit further in history. It's the first century AC, and we are in Rome. This is a very special column of the Trajan Emperor. And why is it special? Because down there we find this text. You'll say, what? This is just a normal text. Yeah, but imagine that from the cave paintings, we came from these very elegant letters that are actually complete, that all the people are putting a lot of effort in the details, and everything's so harmonious and great. So you see how our writing system was developed. And as you can see, these are only cap letters, only big letters. We have no little ones, but later they developed as well. So this is a modern font that you can also find on the web and use in your presentations. It's based exactly on this column of Trajan Emperor. So you can see how we are also using very old system, which is perfectly effective even in nowadays. So as I said, little forms of letters also were developed afterwards. And it was then that actually the text came from the stone to the clay, to the leather, to the paper. And as it goes to the paper, actually more and more books were copied, more and more texts were written. And so everybody wanted to copy the books faster and to read more. Calligraphers were developing this this writing style, let's say, which we call italic. This is more like a handwriting. It's much faster than just writing capital letters. So it helped the books to become more and more popular. And what made the books even more popular, that was the invention of a printing press, which happens in the 15th century. So with the printing press, everybody was using metal letters, and those metal letters actually were made to be so perfect that they look like a calligrapher, a master calligrapher was writing. They didn't want it to look like something printed out. They wanted to look like a really handwritten. But actually, I bet that you cannot read that fast this text. So how fast do you read this? And I bet that you choose the right example, which is the Garamond font. This is a French font, and it was exactly developed because of the need for fast reading. And even later on, the Declaration of the United States was using exactly this font. So you can see how the developing of the writing system is going on. When we go to the Industrial Revolution, and we all know how this event changed the way we live now. And here is something very interesting about fonts, because actually there were so many people developing new, let's say, this modern world business. So they wanted to distinguish from the others, to be unique, different. So you can see that that was the time when fonts actually became so different and so interesting. They wanted to reflect the exact topic of the product or anything else. So you can see how many even fonts were using on one sheet. So everybody was trying to just be the greatest with his font and the unique. And you can see how all the fonts are corresponding to the topic, and they have their specifics and characteristics and their character as a feeling and so on. You can see maybe some familiar brands. And also, I want you to remember this advertisement for the Ford model. And later on, you'll understand why. Okay, and this creepy house here. Good. Now we are going back to our presentation, because something even more more interesting is coming now. And that's it. That is the basic characteristics of forms of the letters. So how to distinguish each font and how to choose the font based on our topic. So we can say that there are two main types of fonts. First one is the left one, which is serif font, and the next one is sans serif font or without serifs. What are serifs? Those are the little endings like drops of the letters, or these, if you look at the letter I, for example, it may look to you like a column, because as you understood, these letters developed with the humankind, with the architecture at that time. So they look a bit like columns. And sans serifs are without such characteristics. They're very pure, look like skeleton a bit, just the basics of the letters. They developed much later in time during the Industrial Revolution, when there was a need for more modern typeface, to just to speak about future and not about past. So when you want to choose some fonts about past, maybe you can choose serif fonts, but when you're talking about future or even nowadays, you should choose sans serif fonts. And there is also another reason why you should use serif fonts in your presentation, and that's because they are much better for fast reading on displays, on screens. So yeah, definitely this will be the better choice for you. Now I'm gonna give you one example with our corporate font, which is Gotham Pro. And that example will be connected with the fact that fonts actually don't come alone. They have families. And what do I mean? These are actually different styles of fonts. So we have the Gotham Pro regular, and maybe some of you may guess that it can have a bold version. Yes, it is, it has. But see how many other versions this font has. And all of them form this font family, as I said. And the best thing about font families is that when you combine some of these styles in one presentation, they still look really nice. And you can combine even Gotham Pro Light with Gotham Pro Black and make a very nice contrast in your presentation. So search for fonts with big families, then you will have much bigger possibilities for a great design on your slides. Next, we are moving to the basic curves, basic emotional curves that actually define all of the objects around us, and not even only objects, everything. So the horizontal line, it's always connected with calmness. We imagine, for example, the horizon of a sea. So this makes us feel really calm and stable. Another one is the curvy line, which is very playful, very friendly, very sweet. So everything that's curly and oval connects to these emotions. And all the lines that have sharp angles, they are really aggressive and rough and definitely not so happy, but really nasty. So yeah, hello, Nelly Stancheva. Nice to see you on our webinar. Okay, so how these emotional curves actually translate to fonts? Well, let's see the basic font characteristics. So first we're gonna start with traditional and modern. I think you will not be so, I mean, you already understood so many things about the history of fonts, so it's very easy for you to distinguish which one is connected to the traditions and which one is connected with the modern world. So as you understood, the traditional one is much more connected with the handwriting. It has a very a lot of symbols that are getting us in the past. And the modern letters are very clean and they take us in the future. So imagine that you have two museums, history museums, and on the left museum, definitely you will expect to see some ancient history artworks. But in the next museum on the right, you will expect to see some history from the from recent times. So this is how fonts are speaking through the way they look like. Let's continue with another very important characteristics, and this is about the heaviness. Some fonts look really light, while others can look very, very heavy. And I'm sure that you will say that the left font looks really light. Yes, it is. It has much more white space out there, so it's very bright and airy. while the other one is very thick, so it's like really heavy. Yeah, so you can see here also the difference. And imagine a person who is going on a diet. So the first one is definitely needing a diet to take some more kilos up, but the other one needs to get rid of some kilos. So this is how those phones are talking to us. And this is how you see two different bodies behind those two texts. Okay, another one is basic and complex. What does this mean? Maybe you already guessed that basics are those sans serif fonts, which, as I said, looks like skeletons. They can also have a very, very interesting individuality, but actually compared to the more complex fonts, they look very basic. So you can use all those basic fonts for universal purposes, but when you want to really emphasize on something very special in your brand or in your topic, then you can go and search for the right font or with some interesting details in it. And when you want to make a choice for yourself, for example, it's very interesting because you can choose the right font that reflects your own personality, and it will give a lot of information about your what you like and what you want to what you love to do, or yeah, whatever you are as a person. So be careful. Talking about style, we are going to the next characteristics, and these are elegant and rough. So in the elegant fonts, you can see that they are really fine. They have very precise details, and also the lines are very smooth and really precisely made, while the rough fonts, they can be really harsh and very dynamic as well. So it depends on what you want to express. So this example here can be even more rough and even more raw. So when you want to go in a cloth shop, if you have those two signs in front of the shop, then you can expect different styles of clothes inside. So this is also one thing that even in commercial world, people are using wisely fonts to orientate their clients to what they should look for. Talking about shops, let's talk about price. So which font can be cheap and which can be expensive? Those who are really special fonts can be the ones that we put a lot of effort and a lot of time into writing them, into drawing them. So you can easily distinguish which font can be cheap and which can be more high quality or luxurious. But here is the time to tell you that actually graphic design as a whole can change totally the picture, so that you can use a cheap font, let's say, in a very luxurious way, and vice versa. So take in mind that graphic designers are also a kind of magicians who can make such shifts. But these are the signs that usually a human can relate to. So when we see such a complex and very interesting and elegant font, we tend to think that this item is very expensive. So when we go to the shop and see these two red wines, we should think that maybe the one on the right is much more high quality than the one on the left. So that's how all those merchants are also tricking all the people there. So be careful. Now, talking about wine, we are of course going to the topic of emotions. So let's see what we have here, how we can distinguish happy from sad ones. I really hope that the left font is going to feel much more happy to you. And you can distinguish this by all those curvy forms. As you remember, the curvy line, it speaks us exactly about happiness, friendship, and so on. And all those sharp and very precise lines are much more cold. Also, you can see that this text is actually slanted on the left side, which is not so usual. And this highlights even more the sadness of this font. So you can even manipulate your text in this technique. I think that you see two very different faces here. One is really smiling in a very cheerful way, and the other one is actually smiling in a very sad way, let's say. So let's go and cheer up the right guy. but also there is a very slight difference between happy and funny. So what is it? This is when we are going to the topic of using our favorite font named Comic Sans. As you can, of course, recognize it on the right, it's actually maybe the most hated font ever, but the fact to be so is because it's not used on its on the right place. So Comic Sans is really inspired by the comic books. It stands, you know, it's aimed to be a font for children. So that's why it's not a good idea to use it for serious topics. And the serious fonts you can, of course, recognize with their strict lines, and they give you much more feeling of they are much more reliable. So yeah, you can make the difference as well. And when you go to the bank, definitely the right bank is not the right place. Or if you see a bank using Comic Sans, I definitely recommend you not going there. Don't make this mistake. Okay, so talking about friendship and bad banks, let's see what we have here. Again, we have those round forms that are so sweet, and they're really warm-hearted. And the other on the other side, we have those fonts that do you see these little sharp endings of the letters? Well, they seem like hurting us. So yes, it's definitely a nasty font. So be aware of this. And I don't know about you, but I connect these with Halloween. So be careful about, be careful if you do make some candies, not sweet, but salty. And I imagine such salty candies on the right side. So yeah, Halloween, hi. And talking about parties, let's see what we have about the characteristics of the sound of the voice. So it's easy now, right? On our right side, we see a very heavy font that has so many details and additional stuff on it, and it's so noisy, and it's really like a very noisy concert. And the other one, I imagine a classical music, so it's a very clean and bright, very light. It can be strict, but also very delicate. So see, we have many different characteristics combined here. And yeah, it can get really noisy out there. So if you are in front of two music halls, be careful at what concert you will go, not to have the situations when you really have to run out very fast. Okay, so let's see then, what about the speed? I ask you now, do you remember the advertisement of the Ford Model F? Well, it was with italic font. And why it is so? Because actually italic font, as we saw, it was developed because of the fast writing. So that's why it connects with speed. It's very vibrant. You can see also the Formula One shows that they also have this slanted on the right side text. And this is very dynamic stuff. While if you want to make the text look really slow and yeah, very calm, you can even put a little bit more spaces between the letters, and that will lose them a little bit and give more relaxation in the whole feeling. So yeah, definitely on the right side we have much slower feeling. So the first guy here will run much faster than the right one. So yeah, take in mind also this when you choose your fonts. And talking about fonts, usually all the people are, well, you read it. Why you need to have specific characteristics? As long as you read it, it's okay. Of course, one of the most important things for your presentations is exactly the readability, because if you put the text there, of course you need to make it so that the people can read it easy and fast. But in the same time, you can give a lot more to your presentation if you choose your font wisely. So I'm gonna give you a demonstration of one real world presentation that we made. It's actually one of my favorite examples because the topic is about skin beauty, and yeah, it's very delicate. So you can see very nice the difference. Okay, so what we have here, can you guess the font? Maybe lots of you are using this font every day without even thinking about it. So this is the font Calibri. That's right, you have a Calibri on all of your computers. It's a system font, it's the default font for your PowerPoint. So yeah, you definitely know this font. And you'll say, okay, this presentation seems nice. Everything is readable. Everything looks fine. What's the problem here? Why we are talking about it? Well, let's see the other one. So here we chose another font, which we thought it's much more delicate, and the feeling is very womanish, and so it speaks about details, about care, about fragiles. Just it's very specific and elegant. So you can see the difference between the heavy Calibri in this case and the very light and womanish avant-garde font. So I really hope you can make the difference. And next time you really think about what kind of emotion you want to add for your presentation through the font. Okay, now we are going back on our presentation to tell you a little bit more about some specifics. I don't know how many of you know about this determine this thing called graphology. Actually, this is the science about handwriting. So a lot of people can tell much, can tell a lot about your personality seeing your handwritings. Maybe you've made such experiments when you was little, or I don't know, I loved this topic in school. This is my favorite thing to guess what my my colleague looks like as a person. So your handwriting can really tell a lot. But in our modern age, the new graphology is actually the font. The choice of the font. And imagine a couple of years ago, we were writing a lot on paper. So there was no chance to make your handwriting much better so that you can show as a really nice person or just to be the best of yourself, to show in the best way. But nowadays you can choose a really nice font that can show the best of you. So this is the new graphology, and if you have to choose a font about yourself, then I recommend to go through the online resources. We'll give you one interesting website with many fonts that you can choose from. So yes, the choice of the font can really reveal a lot about your personality. So be careful. And again, I'm going to just summarize the things about the emotional curves. So as you remember, horizontal lines, they are very calm and steady. All the curvy forms are very playful and happy and friendly, while the very sharp angled lines are aggressive, but also they can be strict and serious. So you can make a very interesting choice about yourself. And don't forget something very important. So this is a topic that many scientists around the world are trying to go deeper and to make more and more researches. So this research is based on is made in 2009, and actually we know that verbal communication is much less than the non-verbal communication as a way of understanding what's behind the words. Verbal communication means exactly the meaning of the of what we are saying, but non-verbal communication, this is all the other stuff like body language, like the way we dress ourselves, or the way we the sound of our voice, or whatever you can imagine. And everything apart from the sense of the text is the non-verbal communication. And because there are so many researches, the results are different, but all of them say that non-verbal communication is much more than even 50% than the verbal communication. So really take care of the of the text, and not only of the idea of the text, but also how the text looks like. The text as an image, because it really tells a lot. So, as I told you, I will show you one really nice website that even we often use for choosing interesting fonts. It's totally free, so you can be sure that you're not illegal. So it's called FontSquirrel, fontsquirrel.com. I'll open it. So you'll see this purple squirrel here, and this is the main homepage. So what we are searching for is this tab where you can search for the exact name of a font, or you can go through and see all the different choices here. There are categories which you will find here, so you can make your research more direct to what you're searching for. So I'm gonna show you just how to download a nice font called Montserrat. Okay, this one. So search, and of course we will look for the download button. So waiting a bit for the internet. And it's so easy to install a font. You'll see now it's just in a few steps. The thing that you actually have to pay attention is that you need to be an admin of your machine. Okay, so this is our Montserrat font. And see that this is a font family. Here it says that it has 36 styles, so we can open it to see all of them, or just click on the download button here. But if you want to open it, I'll wait a bit just to show you how many styles has this font family. So going back to the characteristic to the admin issues, now you really have to be an admin of your computer so that you can install a font. If not, ask your computer supporter to give you permission, because it's really important to download and choose a nice font for all your designs. So you see here all the styles that this font family has. It also has an alternative forms, as you see. So there are so many, and you have a lot of nice choices to make your presentation. So click here on download OTF. This is the format of a font. So we are downloading OTF font. There are also TTF fonts, which will also work on your computer. So I'm going to click Save As. Okay, I'm going to save it on the desktop. So let's go to the desktop and see what happens here. What happens is that this folder is actually a zip folder. So what we do with zip folders, of course, we unzip it. So with right button, I don't know what kind of software you use, but we need to extract all of the content of the font. Again, to choose a destination, so I choose the desktop. Extract, and we'll receive this folder. Oops, sorry for the second time. This folder with all the fonts inside. You see, the ending is OTF, as it was written in the website. So what we should do is to select all the OTF files. Take care, because there is also one text file here. And you might have even a PDF which explains some details concerning the license of the font. So we are selecting all the OTF fonts, and what we need to do is just click with the right button and choose install. You may have this option install for all users or just install. no matter which one you will choose, install the font. You might need to wait a bit, but now we have our Montserrat font installed on our computer. And a very important detail here is that if you have opened already PowerPoint, you need to close it and reopen it again to use the font. And not only PowerPoint, but all the Microsoft softwares. If you use also Excel or another one, you need to close all of them and reopen so that they can recognize the new installed font. Okay, see, it's very simple. Just download, unzip, and install. Okay, so I'll give here the stage to you. So I'll be really happy to answer all of your questions before we summarize the topic we had already. So let's see if we already have a question. Okay, by the way, interesting question, Georgis Latif. Our logo uses the same digits as the ID card in Bulgaria, he says. Well, actually, I'm not exactly sure what kind of font our ID card has in Bulgaria, but you might be right because I don't have the document to make the connection, but yeah, it could be. This is an interesting realization that you made. So yeah, our font is very strict. It's modern, one of the modern fonts. It's one of the simple fonts, so it's universal and can be used for many purposes. It's very easily readable. So yes, it's a good choice for documentation as well. Okay, I'm waiting really for some interesting questions from you. So if you have any more, everything concerning design and fonts, you can ask. Yeah. Boris, I'm looking at him, if he has any questions as well.
I'm still here.
yeah.
Are there any questions from anyone on the chat indeed? Because if not, we can wrap this up with some final advices. So if there are any, because we are almost out of time, we'll kind of wait for one more minute. And if there are no questions and everything is clear, we expect you to deliver and to create stunning slides from now on.
Yes.
Especially when we talk about how you're going to be using fonts in those slides. So more or less 30 more seconds so that we can and Maria can wrap up the event with final advices. Let's see if someone will be so brave to ask something about presentations. By the way, a lot of things were said and a lot of advices were given here about fonts. Just don't forget that at the end of the day, everything that you hear is something that you can obviously consider, think about. It's very important, on and on and on. I just want to add something that if you are working in a big company, or even if it's not a big company, medium size or a small size company, as in our case, we have a corporate font, let's call it corporate, even though we're not a corporate organization, but still, we're an organization that defined the font for our company. So if you have such defined, you have to ask whether or not it is allowed to you to change that. If you have the freedom to choose any font, then all of those advices are very much applicable. However, and you have to consider them. However, if you have a company font, then the initial thought and the rule of thumb is to first start with your font. And maybe in the meantime, while you are building your slides, ask whether or not you have the freedom to use something else because of the topic or because it's not in front of like people inside of the company or some other reason. But if you have a company font, maybe it's a very good idea for you to start from the company font. And then if you get an approval from the branding, from the PR team, from the marketing team, then and only then choose another font. If you, however, have complete freedom, well, all of those advices are something that we expect you to now consider, because we have your, we can see your emails, we have your registrations, kind of, even though that kind of sounds scary. But we know who you are, and we are going to keep an eye on your presentations from now on. And if we see you using Calibri or Comic Sans, then, and only then, some bad things may happen, who knows. Okay, there are no more questions, so let's wrap this up.
Okay, good. So I want to highlight some things to really remember and always keep in mind. So do use Universal Sans Serif fonts for your presentations, especially when the topic is about something in the future or something digital, or even just for nowadays. Of course, when you talk about history, you may choose a serif font, but again, about presentations, it's better to use sans serif fonts. And please don't use too complicated fonts with so many details and fluffy stuff around. It's not readable, it's too much for serious presentations, so consider this again. Another thing is to search for big font families so that you can have a nice variety and to make a nice contrast between light and thick, heavy fonts so that all the presentations look really eye-catching. When you have a nice contrast, they are really eye-catching. But in the same time, don't mix too many of those fonts because it may come become really a mess. Choose 1, 2 to 3 styles to use in the whole presentation, and this will be a much more successful way to make your presentation. Another thing just to really stress on is to watch out, because really the fonts tells really stories. So choose wisely and be really aware of how the fonts can impact on your presentations. And be sure that a font can really take your presentation on a really high level. So thank you for listening. And I hope we can connect further and talk about fonts, about presentations, about whatever that's connected with communication design. So I'll be really glad to answer your questions and keep in touch.
Okay, everyone, that's that for today. So we hope that it was useful, and we hope that, and we are really looking forward to, some things are falling here in this room, by the way. The previous time there was a dog barking outside. This time something is falling in this room. So again, thank you very much for staying with us. Hopefully you learned something new and you're going to apply it, because indeed, as Maria told you, all those things will help you, even if you're not a designer to actually, exactly, if you're not a designer, to create slides that look on a completely different level. So again, see you soon. And yeah, please take a look if you want to follow our work. We share a lot of things in regards to presentations. Here are our Maria's contacts. You can find us on many more than just those platforms. Yeah. Have a great evening or day, depending on which time zone you are at. And see you soon. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
And that's that. So let's stop the share first, and then let's end the meeting. And end the meeting.